welcome to another crafting video. Well, we'll see. So, at the Dollar Tree, the faithful Dollar Tree, we got these two little dressers. Obviously, they're not the size of Barbie. No, no, no. But we're going to paint them and spruce them up. And we're going to make them into a Barbie desk. Yeah. So, these will be the ends of the desk, and then I'll have a piece of wood. Thinking this thing that was given to me, not, obviously not this long, I need to cut it, but it's given to me, it's nice and pretty and shiny. It's just the right width, and so we just need to cut the length that we want. So I'm thinking that it's not super strong, so we might end up gluing it to something else and make it stronger. So let's pop these bad boys open. And let's paint them. So I have my tray here, my crappy Dollar Tree brush. Yeah. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna paint it all white first, and then I'll go back and add some color to it. Color really like strong. So I have our white paint. If we really want. This one, but it says ice crystals, glamour dust, ultra fine glitter paint. Well, that's not really what I was going for. Well, let's see how it turns out. I was planning on doing the glitter like as a. Yeah, no, that's not going to work. That's just adding glitter, so we definitely need to get it down there first. And then after the white, we can spruce things up with a little bit. Alright, so let's try this again with the white. Yeah, there we go. We have white. This might take a few coats. I don't know. We shall see. I am not the best painter. It's all over my fingers, I'm sure. I splattered that on my shirt. It just made it worse. Look at me. Well, I got it all over my hands. Well, this shirt is worn now. Don't mind me. I'm just a mess. See, I told you I'd be a messy painter. My problem is I gotta slow down. I wanna do things fast. It's not white, it's a white wood, but not white white. No, that's not white white. This is even real wood, awesome.
I wonder if the drawers come out.
They don't.
Well, the bottom out?
No.
Why?
They're just for looks.
Mom.
What?
I want the drawers to come out.
No, I'm sorry. This one is painted. Now we gotta let it dry. Let it dry. I'm gonna go clean up. Have it too long. Let me put over here. Oh, I made a score. I'm cutting it at, almost 10 1/4. Almost a 10. So, cutting it kind of did that to us, so we're going to have to try to clean that up, make it look cute again, or we're just going to have to figure out something to put on the end to make it look good. So, we'll see. I don't know if this is going to be helpful to it or not, but we're going to try it out. But I'm just like cutting, trimming it at the end where it was kind of frayed and stuff. To make it look better, more of a straight line. You know me, not really a straight line, because I can never do that anyway. No, it definitely doesn't look better, so we're going to have to find a way to make it look better. We find some beaded ribbon or something and just put that on there. Ends. Give the desk some flair. I don't know. So the desk is still drying. The top seems to be pretty dry already. A few wet spots. But for the most part, it's pretty dry. So I think what we're gonna do, since we don't see the top anyway, right? I'm gonna get this started. So we're probably gonna want, since it has like fake drawers, we probably want it pretty close to the ends, right? Not all the way to the end. and kind of center, because this is a little bit bigger than the wood. So that's kind of what the desk is going to look like. You see the paint underneath there not being completely dry. And it doesn't actually seem to look pretty weak in the middle, so that's pretty good. So as this dries just a little bit more, I'm going to get the hot glue going. Yeah, hot glue. And I'm going to search for some ribbon or something. The lamp is huge, but there's a lamp. All right, back. Hot glue is on and ready. So we're going to put some glue on here. Oh, it's really hot. And hold it out. Oh, we're holding, we're holding, we're holding, we're holding. Okay, so with that said, I found some ribbon choices. We have this really sheer brown. I don't know that it would entirely do what we're looking for, the hiding the sides, so we're going to turn into that. I found this bag of silver and gold ribbon thing. The main thing is, will I have enough to cover the hole? So this is like a metallic thing. I don't know if we have enough for that. Oh wait, we would. We have a whole other thing too. So, but we also have, like, because I'm going to do it on this side with cameras. This is another silver. This one looks more like rope. So, we did it. Ooh, I like it. Adds to it. So let's see what this one is. I like this metallic blue, so let's see what it does to the sides. Ooh, I don't like it as much. So fun. But I do like this gold ribbon thing. The other one that kind of caught my eye was this one that's kind of a combination of gold and silver and white. It looks super cute. I think I like the prime looking one. The other ones look too wide. But I did pull this one out because I really love it, and I think we could potentially cut it in half, although my ability to cut in a straight line kind of sucks. Unless we just want to do like a hangover in it. That's a possibility. Yes, okay. Oh yeah. So, what do you think? Probably too much. We'll probably just get this one. But I also got beads out. If you want to do beads, get this out and let's see how it looks. So these are kind of metallic-y. And they probably go right there. It does. I'm not saying it's not good. I'm just saying I don't like it for this. So say no to this, and I think we're gonna do this twine looking stuff. So we're gonna clean out this other ribbon. Oh, we have just plain gold too, what do you think? Too much? So, I'm thinking that this is going to be the front of it. There's not as much overhang because I didn't center it properly. So, yeah, no. Me and my bad skills. I think that's going to be like perfect to give it the little detail we're looking for. So I'm going to use hot glue, and I'm going to start over here and just put it on the ends. I didn't say ends, I meant the whole thing, but and then hold it for it to dry a little bit. And then switch it to this side. So I don't know if you guys have personally noticed that when I'm really concentrating, I stick out my tongue. Something that I've always done, so I'm pretty non-aware that it's happening until recently when it's been made aware every time I do it. So I come looking for it. It's like, oh, yep, there it is. Betty's concentrating. So, anyway. So if you see that, I'm sorry, and hopefully it doesn't offend you, but I'm really just concentrating. It's nothing against anybody. Alright, I'm gonna put glue on this side. We might have enough to go all the way around. Oh my goodness. So I don't understand Instagram. But I did install it, and apparently a long time ago I had it, and I obviously didn't understand it then either. So, but I opened another one, or not another one, I reopened it, added some new things. So now I have an Instagram. So if you want to look me up on there, it's BettyJoJo72. And just, you know. It's just a bunch of pictures of me and my daughter and things that we've done. I've added one of the crafts that we've done on there, but I haven't added much more. I'm still trying to figure it out. All I really understand is you follow people. It's kind of like Pinterest, in my opinion, but mainly with people. Kind of what people are doing in their lives. I don't know. I'm also not really good with the hashtag thing, but I am trying to figure that out. So, if you see me trying to use hashtags, try to be gentle. Because I have no clue what I'm doing. I'm faking it. I'm faking it to make it. Alright. I'm going to cut the extra off. We had enough, guys. We had enough. And some extra. Looky there. We might have to apply that somewhere else. Just to make it a little more uniform, I guess. I'm trying to cut this frayed part. Oh, it's not working. Oh no, it's coming undone. More glue! More glue! Burning my fingers. Yeah, it's good. It's burning your fingers. Alright. should we paint these another color or just leave them? Pretty professional, other than this part here. I don't know that I have anything too unique that I could use to cover that up. And I do have some little walls here. I guess I could make something. So, this will be another video another time, but in this little Frozen box, that used to have Frozen earrings and things in it, has to clean out my jewelry box. So I went through and looked for things that didn't have matches and were broken. So this thing is full of all kinds of mainly earrings that are broken or pieces are missing. So I'm gonna look through here real fast to try to find something that would look good in that spot. Now, granted, I don't have two of anything to make it uniform, except for these red balls for a bracelet broke, but. I found this one, it kind of goes with a skinny bowl, and it's got a little mouthful. So I'm going to take my water colors here, and I'm going to cut the back of the earring off. So it draws your attention to it, but not to the fact that it's the frayed part of the yarn. My cat is currently trying to climb into my dresser drawer that I left open. He got stuck the last time he did that. Apparently he did not learn his lesson. So I don't know. It looks a little crooked now, but does that look okay? That adds a little flair to the desk. A little bit of flair. I'm peeling off the extra glue that's on top because nobody wants that on their desk. I think if we added the lamp, oh yeah, it will turn on. Boom. Boom. Say hello. We add a chair and she's golden. She could be professor. Look at my styling desk. We're going to add a lamp to the other side. We have two. So I think this is coming out nicely and I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. So, what shall we do here? Do we add some color? I currently have teal and this burgundy pink, which I don't know that goes really well. Or we could just glitterify it with the glitter, the clear stuff that we have. Or we could put the color in and glitterify it. Biggest thing. We could glitterify it and take this and wrap it around the base. Add a little flare there. I do like it on the base of the dresser too. Well, I guess we'll add some give, so. Fantastic desk that we just made. Now you can always use different things for the top, like cardboard or whatever. You can still style it if you want. Regular household item works great. I just happened to get that. If anybody was wondering, all these end up in my other files. I was currently thinking about it. So I still have to figure out how to make chairs, but. Simple. Well, if you like that video, make sure you hit the like button, and if you want to see more videos, hit subscribe. I'll try to get more consistent on making content, but sometimes it just doesn't happen. But anyway, thanks for watching. Have a great day.